Attorney at law and founder of the National Center for Legal Aid and Human Rights, Mary Francis, believes that CSA President Mary Isaac may have a strong case based on Ms. Isaac's own assertion that the meeting to oust her out of office was unconstitutional. And Ms. Francis believes the dispute may be best settled in court. The human rights attorney believes that whatever the outcome, the current fracas will not work in the interest of the trade union movement.
The best way to have the matter resolved is probably to take it to the courts, because there seems to be a case for Mary Isaac also. There seems to be a case for her in terms of she has been stating the whole meeting was unconstitutional, and on top of that she says it has been a deprivation of a right to freedom of association. And I think there is somewhere in the constitution of the union which says that persons can become, in other words, the terms and the requirement for membership, assessing membership or becoming a member, issues such as race, religion, politics will not be taken into consideration. And once you are a valid member of the association, you can vie for executive office.
Ms. Francis is also of the view that the petitioners may have acted hastily. But then again, as she puts it, the argument is not one that is cut and dry. Ms. Francis says that rather than engaging in internal squabbles, it is far better to look at the bigger picture. In this case, according to her, it would be the irreparable damage that can be caused by way of division in the union. Having said that, Ms. Francis believes the Mary Isaac scenario could set a new precedent as to how the trade union conducts its business.
It's a pity that is the way the matter has actually evolved, and which is not too good for the union. I think there was a bit of hastiness on the part of the petitioners. Then again, I'm an outsider, and it's up to them to express their opinions and their feelings about their union, how they want their union to go. That is the other aspect of it. It's a union and the members. And they also, if somebody is representing you, you're looking for certain qualities in the person. So you see, the argument is not cut and dry. But I think, however, the provisions should probably shed a little light on the future for maybe Mary Isaac.
Despite calls by Ms. Isaac for the cancellation of a CSA meeting she deemed unconstitutional, the meeting went ahead as planned, and by the time it was over, she was voted out of office. However, Ms. Isaac says she will not be resigning. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.